Hello, my name is Cream, and welcome back to Hearts of Iron 4. New expansion was released, so let's play it. Okay, new game. So there are few new nations which I definitely want to play. Mexico, Netherlands, United States also have new Focus 3, so definitely want to try it. But for now, we're gonna be playing as UK. There are few achievements which we could do. Like, I really thought about playing as Mexico. They have achievement to put Trotsky in power and then puppet Soviet Union. Definitely something I want to do. But right now, first, let's just learn how to play this game. Because let's be honest, now playing as Mexico will be harder than before, because then now, as people in Paradox put it, if you are lucky, then you will just have one civil war. Let's be honest, best course of action is to destroy the United States, or it would be in previous patch, and until this patch, it would be the best course of action to attack the United States as soon as possible, before they will be too strong. Like, there was achievement for Mexico before, which basically meant that you, as Mexico, you would retake Western America. Western part of the United States. Where is it? I know that I've done that, so it should be somewhere. Oh yeah, Revenge of Montezuma. Restore the old borders of the United States as Mexico. Now, that will be a lot harder. And let's be honest, defeating Soviet Union as Mexico will be also really, could be really hard. Especially if Soviet Union will win war against German Reich. Okay, and taking the United States as Mexico now will probably a little harder if it's even doable. Okay, so what achievements I want to do as UK? Definitely this one, we could build 9 battle cruisers. That definitely should be doable. This could be doable too. Like, we're gonna be at war with someone, so we could do 1,000 mines. We will see. Yeah, Britzkrieg. Definitely something I want to do now. Has complete focus the King's Party, is infection with German Reich, and we must fully control the France, and we need to destroy France. Yes, definitely, that should be definitely doable. We will see. As Communist United States, nope. Yeah, and this one, William Wallis. As UK, put Edward VIII in power, enforce an American monarchy and have both it and Scotland as subjects. I think this one is definitely those two, Blitzkrieg and William Wallis, are definitely or should be doable. Hopefully. Like, okay, we must finish King's Party. Here we need to finish King's Party too, so I think it's doable. As UK, incorporated Federation of entire British Empire, has completed focus Imperial Federation. Well, we will see. Probably not. So we need to finish King's Party, and this one is Imperial Federation. So let's look at our focuses. Imperial Federation and King's Party. Let's find it. Revisit Colonial. Okay, so I think we need to do this. Yeah, King's Party, we need to get here. So we need to do a change in course, and the second focus was what? Imperial Federation. Well, who knows where that could be. It probably will be somewhere here, but question is where. Okay, we're gonna go here. God save the king. Okay, those two are doable. So we could get up here with King's Party. Imperial Federation, or somehow it was called, like something like that. Oh, alliance with Germany, definitely something I want to do. Well, we definitely need that if we want to get that one achievement. Okay, probably not here. Study as she goes. Imperial Federation, home defense, masks, Second Netherlands. Some interventions. Well, doesn't matter. If you're gonna find it in future, we're gonna find it in the future. For now, our main objective is to get King's party. What are we gonna get here? It's gonna take only 45 days. This is nice. A change in course, which grants political power gain plus 7%. Definitely, I'm definitely okay with that. More force support, definitely okay with that. More commands, I definitely don't like that. I think I'm gonna be okay with that, so this is possible, and very likely I'm gonna choose that. Revisit colonial policy. Or maybe here we would have that federation. Well, since you're gonna be fascists, I don't think that it does matter. But this is towards a colonization, no chance. This we can say definitely no to. This is big no-no. Service overseas, so we're gonna reinforce the empire. What are you gonna get? Higher stability. If the colonization has not been achieved within 2 years of becoming communist, a civil war will start. Well. Limited rearmament. So, 7 factories. What was that last thing? Cryptologic bomb? We must be at war with German Reich. Well, I don't think we're gonna do that, so. Yield for now. Let's have a change in course. Resources. Well, resources, definitely we won't do anything here. 357 days, so let's take too long. Okay, as always. Fuel. Oh, we definitely need more fuel. 47, so that will take. Construction level 1, basic machine tools. Let's go with mechanical computing. And the last thing will be support weapons. So we have 3 civilian factories. In that case, let's build military factories. For now. Okay, let's build a few military factories. What's next? We have 3 military factories. And Eurocards. Do we tanks? Well, we definitely need more support equipment, infantry equipment. Let's produce more total artillery. And that's enough. Okay, tanks? Screw you. I'm not creating you at this moment. Fighters? Screw bombers. Let's get closer support. Let's assign. I think 1 military factory will be enough. Maybe we could get carrier naval bombers. I guess we will need them too. And let's assign everything else to infantry equipment. Now, naval dockyards. Well, we are producing a lot of... Oh, those ships are almost finished. Okay, let's finish those ships. We have tons of fleets. I hate this already. Oh, here in Scotland we have our pride of navy. We have decisions. What can we decide? We can demand reduce Dutch trade with Germany. Not at this moment, but I may should do it. War propaganda, probably not. Second London Naval Conference. Well, we should definitely not do it. Expand Burma Road. Nothing we can do here. We can. Oh, for influence. The countries we have taken under our protection deserves only the best and most equitable governments. Destabilizing influences from alien ideologies must be curtailed. Okay, for now I'm gonna say no to that because I don't know what's gonna happen when we won't be democratic anymore. So we have 46 troops. Okay, let's get our entire army here to Europe. What are good troops? Okay, we have only 16 good infantry. You kinda suck, right? Cover of 12? Well, you are not that bad. I'm running horses. You will join this army too. Oh, we have tank here. Okay, we're gonna keep one tank. So we have 20 divisions. You guys definitely stay here. Let's see what we're gonna get. And we can start playing. No divisions in basic training. Well, Since we don't have infantry equipment and we don't have infantry equipment, it will take 1 year for us to get to have enough infantry equipment. So for now, this not proves anything. Okay, what ships do we have here? For screw that. I want. Okay, let's do it again. Scotland, South England, Sargasso Sea. That's in North Atlantic. Oh no, that's some definite. No, damn it. Maybe not Atlantic. It's definitely somewhere in Atlantic. Scotland, Northern England, Southern England, Iberian regions. No. Scotland, South England, Southern England, Scotland. You guys get to Portsmouth. Like right now, I want to know what fleets do we actually have. So I want to merge them together and then we gonna do something about that. You're not moving anymore? Who are you? You get a Portsmouth too. Now you guys, I'm gonna merge you together. Oh, there's another fleet here. Merge together. Yep, that's done. So, let's do it again. Egypt, Sub-Saharan Africa, South China, India, Egypt, Iberian region, South Georgia Sea, that's in South Atlantic, South-Saharan Africa, Southern England. You guys, I want you to meet here in Alexandria. Now, the Pacific Ocean, Asia. You guys will meet here in Singapore. And that should make. That should make three fleets. Okay, of course. Oh, yeah, I didn't read description. As war tensions mount, it is clear that our current political leadership is incapable of protecting the nation's interests. The time has come for a drastic departure from the politics of the last few decades. King George V dies. His Majesty George King V, the King of the United Kingdom and the British Dominions, an Emperor of India, has passed away. His quiet calm and devotion to his subjects saw the empire through the both Great War and the Great Depression. His son will assume the mantle as King Edward VIII, but there are already concerns that he will be too independent of thought. Stanley Baldwin and Neville Chamberlain are preparing to ensure that he will accept direction from Prime Minister and the Cabinet. May he rest in peace. Oh, we are losing stability. But it sucks. But soon we're gonna be gaining a lot of political power. Or not a lot, but like, we're gonna be gaining political power. So, now, with King's Party, we must wait for Edward VIII, Mary Wallis Simpson. Now we can revert colonial policy. No. I don't want to do the colonization. So screw that. Reinforce the empire. More stability would be quite nice. Especially since we are now losing stability. Automated realm. Oh, screw it, let's get similar factories. Our new approach for domestic politics and international relations require a healthy military to support it. In preparation, we should begin to expand upon our civil industry, so that it may form a stable foundation for a future expansion of our military industry in due time. And we can do some decision. Grow rubber plantation in Nigeria. Demand reduced trade. Dutch trade? Why not? And what was the second thing? Yeah, grow rubber plantations in Nigeria. Let's do that. Oh, ships! Your five finally arrived! Egypt, you guys merge together. And Malaya, you guys merge together too. So we now have three fleets, great. For now, I'm not gonna do anything with them. Like, but in future, we will definitely remove those submarines. So we have 3 battlecruisers. We need... Oh, ships. That I forgot. You guys will definitely merge with... You want to reserve? Why are you freaking kidding me? North Atlantis, what's that? I'm gonna rename you. This is definitely not Atlantic Fleet. This is... Mediterranean Fleet. This will be... This... Okay, let's remove that one. This will be Main Fleet. Main Fleet. And East Indies Fleet. We can call it East Indies, no problem. So, you will join Main Fleet. Main Fleet. Main Fleet. Everyone will join Main Fleet. Like, I don't know who we're gonna be at war. Well, most likely France, since my plan is to take a lot of France. But we definitely need the best navy here in Europe. Asia, no one really cares that much about. Are we still moving? Oh yeah, we still some troops going to UK. So with our current production, we are. Okay, so it's still gonna take year for us to have enough infantry equipment. So what laws do we have? Let's look. 7 in 7 economy sucks. Volunteers only, well, that sucks too. What can we do? We can demand reduce trade Dutch trade with Germany? We've already done that. When effect removed, if Netherlands cave to our demands, we will receive amount of political power equal to the total amount invested by all gateway to Europe participants. Grant this amount to political power plus 10. So we won't gain anything at this moment. Oh, you guys, I'm gonna create a new theater for you, and you guys will be higher priority. And you know what? Let's train 2 more divisions. You can be deployed down here in Sussex. Events or decision amount? Okay, what's gonna happen? In order to limit expenditures and avoid for mutually ruinous naval arm races, the great naval powers of the world have signed a number of treaties limiting the overall size of their fleets and the size of each individual ship. As signatory of these treaties, we are subject to certain restrictions, but as long as our opponents follow them as well, the balance of power should be maintained. We are currently between 90 and 100% of the British Britain in capital ship strength. I don't know what's gonna happen here, like, there's no button we can click. We are not withdrawing from naval treaties since we don't have 150 political power. I don't know what we can do here. I don't see any button we can click. Well, it's gonna be fun. We will see what's gonna happen in 19 days. Now, you guys, who's gonna be our leader here? Level 5 guy, definitely. Harold Alexander. Promotion cost minus 50%. What are you? War hero. Promotion cost minus 50%. Army reassignment duration plus 50%. Reconnaissance, you know what, William Slim, you're gonna be leader of Pink Army, and who's gonna be Field Marshal here? Alan Brooke? Nope. Baron Montgomery, even if he's level 4 and this guy's level 5, this guy has a lot more traits, so I want him to be a leader. You guys gonna be led by Claude Oshnick, and your Field Marshal will be Alan Brooke. At least for now. Now we have 3 naval. We have. Oh, frag! We finished a lot of ships. Oh, second London Navy Treaty signed. No, that sucks. Now we need new ship. What's that button? Oh. Great variant. Well, maybe better submarines? Oh, those guys can create mines. Oh! Eric Cruiser. I just want to know. I want destroyers, all of you. Damn it, how I'm gonna split anything? Unlock speed of disabled. I want this enabled. Create new task force. All destroyers? That is definitely a mistake here. This should be destroyer. Okay, not you. Now, where are missions? Split, half, reserve fleet, distribute. Automatic split of. Okay, let's enable automatic split off. Repair priority high. Okay, where are... Oh, you will have some guy. Let's go with Andrew Cunningham. How should I give you... How can I give you orders? Oh, James Falls Somersville, you're gonna be... Oh, nothing. But there is no admiral. Okay. Reserve fleet for this theater? Why are you reserved? Okay, you will be led by this... what's that? Green water expert? Shallow sea? Nope. You guys, how the hell can I give you orders? You can be green, I don't really care. Okay, screw it. For now, get to Ports Mode. Decision! Oh, no, decisions. My research. 1946. Let's research Hurricane. Oh, that was industry. We could defend the research synthetic auto experiments. Oh, no. Let's get to disperse industrial one. Oh, yeah, we need to build a chip. We definitely need to build battle cruisers. Can we do them? Battleship, carrier, early, heavy ship. I don't see better cruisers. Can we research them? Or did we research them? Or do we need to create battle cruisers? And the question is, what are battle cruisers? Well, I definitely know that we have battle cruisers here. Battleship, carrier, yeah, that's you. Battleship, heavy ship. That's you. Early heavy ship, how? Admiral class. Okay, let's find Admiral class. This one. So this is battle cruiser. But let's remove it. Can we create variant? Let's look what can we do. Oh, we cannot have that much stuff anymore. Heavy engine. We can get for secondary battery. Level 2. Problem is we don't have any experience, so we cannot do it. But what's that? Anti-air? Anti-air. Light attack. So we already have everything. Now we don't have aircraft facilities. Screw aircraft facilities. Let's get anti-air. Oh, we need experience, which we do not have. Okay, screw it for now. Let's build our Let's put our armor class. We can have only 5 dockyards. Okay, in that case, let's produce more of them. Let's build another ship. Let's build another battle cruiser. Oh, and let's start building another battle cruiser. Oh, and all of you, you join main fleet. You know what? No, main fleet, you will join East Indian fleet. East Indies fleet, you will join Mediterranean fleet. And you, last two of you, you will join main fleet. We can modify our government. What we can do? We can do political advisors. Any good political advisors, like, by good I mean someone who can give us political power. Political power! Philip Kerr, I love him already. Oh, more political power. Wow, okay, this is only 5%. Okay, Philip Kerr, I'm probably gonna hire you. This guy's also nice. Let's hire Philip Kerr. Let's get more political power. So Edward 8 is now... Oh, focus. Damn it, I should have chosen that sooner. General rearmament, so there need to be more war tension. More war tension, not really. So, in that case, let's go here, let's reinforce the Empire, let's get more stability up. Let's get our stability up. Our Empire is vast, and despite our power, we weakly defend it. To combat this, we need to encourage Imperial patriotism through the realm. And you know what? Let's finish first episode here. If you enjoyed this first episode, please continue watching, and have a nice rest of your day. Goodbye!